In the seafood industry, about 30% of our seafood is illegal, unreported, unregulated.
But a new movement is taking hold of the industry, one that uses blockchain technology to track where our food comes from and ensures everyone gets paid fairly along the supply chain.
Most of the farmers here now have farming as their only source of income.
The grand picture that we're working towards is truly inclusive business models that work for everybody, for the fishermen and the farmers and those actors through the supply chain.
Having blockchain traceability is a game changer. My name is Juni Pratiwi. I am the project manager of ASIC, Asian Seafood Improvement Collaborative. Indonesia, even though we are five top largest shrimp producers globally, Indonesia is not price maker, we are price taker.
Fishers and farmers are arguably the most critical part of the seafood supply chain, but they typically get paid the least.
Pekerjaan saya petani tambak, bindu sama panami, sama bandeng.
Haji is just one of the many farmers in Indonesia that is struggling to make ends meet as fishers and farmers are increasingly paid less while other players profit.
Saya mulai nambah 96, mulai sekarang, sampai sekarang ini, tambah repot.
Here's the problem. Seafood prices are rising and there's often a 35 to 45% price markup by the time it reaches consumers. But very little of that profit makes it back to the fishers and farmers. So could we use technology to learn where our food comes from and ensure that fishers and farmers are paid fairly? That's where Fishcoin comes in.
Fishcoin was born at the idea of the token incentivizing data sharing.
As seafood travels from the fisher to a buyer, data about where and when the fish was caught is often handwritten on notepads and spreadsheets, which can be easily falsified before it reaches the shelves at grocery stores.
For years, I've been working as an auditor. So I would go to seafood processing facilities in and around this region, and often the paper comes in. I would joke that the ink is still wet.
So Alistair and his team created a type of cryptocurrency called Fishcoin, so fish buyers can pay fishers and farmers for their catch data.
Fishcoin allows seafood buyers to purchase the traceability data.
And that data lives on the blockchain, which is basically a database that prevents the data from being altered later, traveling with the seafood all the way to your dinner table. On the Fishcoin app or webpage, a fisher enters the seafood species, quantity, and data. Then the fisher negotiates with the buyer for how much that data is worth.
So for example, if it's $100 worth of seafood, they might ask for a dollar, so 1%, and then puts that information on the blockchain. It's that simple.
Fishers and farmers can redeem Fishcoin tokens to pay for goods and services like cell phone plans, utility bills, and groceries.
We can support them by giving this reward and hopefully reducing the burden to cover their daily expenses.
Blockchain transparency systems aren't perfect. They rely on the trust that information is entered accurately. But false information is less likely to be entered when it can be tracked. Vignesh Iyer designed Fishcoin with this in mind.
I've been obsessed with this phrase of automation of trust. And we see blockchain as an infrastructure that automates trust. Data captured at the point of transaction is always invaluable. Once you incentivize this, that's how accurate data comes on its own. Blockchain allows the marginal players to come to mainstream. That's the biggest advantage blockchain provides.
Data traceability isn't just a flash in the pan. New US and EU standards mean that visible supply chains will be required more and more, and blockchain technology can be used as a tool to do this. As consumers, we want to know where our food comes from. And with blockchain, it could be as simple as scanning a QR code at the grocery store. The cost to know where our food comes from could be marginal for consumers, while transforming the lives of people who are responsible for catching our seafood.
It's mission critical that we get traceability. If we can't identify, verify, and reward these fishers and farmers that are producing in a sustainable and responsible manner, we can't transform the industry.